Hi everyone, the crop which we are going to discuss today is about groundnut, which is scientifically known as Araxis hypogea lineus. Now let's discuss in detail, starting with few introduction. Groundnut, also known as peanut, is one of the important legume crops of tropical and semi-arid tropical countries. It provides a major source of edible oil and vegetable proteins. They can be eaten raw, cooked, or roasted. Among the oilseed crops, groundnut has first place in India. One very unique characteristic of the crop is that their flowers are produced above ground and, after fertilization, pegs move toward the soil, forming the seed-containing pods underneath the soil, a feature which is known as geocarpy. Next, we will see about the importance of the crop. It is a useful rotation crop. Being a legume, it can fix atmospheric nitrogen through the root nodules. It has the advantage of generating residual nitrogen in the soil, which benefits subsequent crops, especially when groundnut residues are incorporated into the soil during plowing, thereby maintaining soil fertility. It is also an efficient cover crop for lands exposed to soil erosion. Now let's know together about the origin of the crop. The cultivated groundnut or peanut is considered to have originated in Brazil in South America, where closely related ancestors have been identified. Next, we will discuss about the geographic distribution. The most important groundnut growing countries are India, China, Nigeria, Sudan, and USA. India occupies the first place in acreage and second in production. In India, its cultivation is mostly confined to states like Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Maharashtra. The other important states where it is grown are Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, and Punjab. Gujarat is the largest producer of groundnut. Now we will discuss about the classification of the crop. The genus Araxis belongs to the family Fabaceae. There are two botanical types of groundnut, that is hypogea, also known as spreading type, and fastigiata, also known as buns type. Now let's see about the hypogea subspecies. The hypogea subspecies do not flower on the main stem and, in general term, mature later, have a high water requirement, have alternate branching patterns, and produce large seeds. Hypogea hold two market types, that is runner and virginia. Next is about the fastigiata subspecies. The fastigiata subspecies produce flower on the main stem, have sequential branching, and have a lower water requirement and produce smaller seeds. Fastigiata has also two market types, that is Spanish and Valencia. Next is about the climatic requirement of the crop. Groundnut is grown on a large scale in almost all the tropical and subtropical countries of the world. They grow favorably within temperature ranges of 20 and 30 degrees Celsius. Productivity drastically reduces when grown below 16 degrees Celsius and above 32 degrees Celsius. The crop requires about 500 to 700 mm of well-distributed rainfall over the total growing period. During ripening period, it requires about a month of warm and dry weather. Next is about the soil requirement of the crop. Care must be taken during land selection, as the pods are produced underneath the ground surface. They are best grown under well-drained, light sandy soil, loamy sand or sandy loam. Heavy clay soil are not suitable because lifting during harvesting operation becomes too difficult. Light texture soils facilitates easy penetration of bags, resulting in proper development of pods. In addition to this, this also adds in easy harvesting and minimizing pod losses during harvest. Ideal pH condition ranges between 6 to 6.5. Next, we will see about the popular varieties of the crop. As a bunch type variety, Jyoti, Kishan, TMV11, 12, AK12, 24, Junagar 11, ICGS 1, 10, 11, 44, JL 24 are popularly known. As a spreading type, Chandra type 28, 64, TMB 1, 3, M13, 37, Bikram, Virginia, Gangapuri, Goderi, 2-3 can be grown. Resistant varieties against aflatoxin are CZC27 and Fezpur. Next, we will discuss about how land preparation should be carried out. Land should be prepared early before the onset of rain so as to able to start sowing early in the rains. Groundnut is a deep-rooted crop. However, considering its underground pod-forming habit, deep plowing should not be done. Deep plowing encourages development of pod deeper layer of the soil, which makes harvesting difficult. One plowing with soil-turning plow followed by two harrowing would be sufficient to obtain a good surface tilt up to 12 to 20 cm depth. Next is about the optimum sowing time. In India, groundnut can be grown in the following three seasons. First one is Kharif. They are usually planted with the onset of rains in the month of May to June. Most groundnut in India are sown during this season. Next is Rabi season groundnut. Crop is usually sown in the month of September and November. These are done in areas where temperature does not limit production. The last one is summer season crop. It is sown in the month of January. This is done in some region where irrigation facilities are available. Next, we will see about the seed treatment. It is recommended to inoculate the seeds with proper strands of rhizobium, particularly if the groundnuts are being grown either for the first time in a new field or after a long period gap. For control of soil-borne diseases, seeds should be treated with insecticides and fungicides mixture. Commonly used chemicals are Captan, Tiram, Carvendazim, or Mancozeb. Seed treatment with Trichoderma viridi or Trichoderma hergenium at the rate of 4 to 5 g per kg of seeds also help in managing seed and soil-borne diseases. One very important point what I would like to mention is about the seed dormancy of the crop and how the seed dormancy can be overcome. Virginia varieties have post-harvest seed dormancy. If such varieties are to be sown immediately after harvest, the seeds should be thinly spread over a tarpaulin or plastic seeds and spread thoroughly with Itrel 39 EC at the rate of 5 milliliter per liter of water and air dried just before sowing. Next, we will discuss about sowing methods. Three systems of groundnut sowing methods are usually followed. They are sowing on flat bed or ridges separated by furrows or broad bed and furrow systems. The crops should preferably be sown in lines. Raised beds and furrows help conserve soil moisture, minimize soil erosion, draining of excess water, and add in aeration and easy cultural operations. Next, we will see about the optimum seed rate, spacing, and sowing depth. Seed rate vary according to the types of groundnut which is going to be grown. For one style varieties, 80 to 100 kg of seed rate is sufficient. And spacing to be maintained is 30 cm between the rows and 10 cm between the plants within rows. And for spreading type varieties, 60 to 80 kg of seed is sufficient. And spacing to be maintained is 40 cm between the rows and 10 cm between the plants within the rows. Sowing depth to be maintained is 5 cm in case of heavy soil to 6 cm in case of light soil. If planting is done deeper than 7.5 cm, germination percentage decreases. Now we will discuss about manures and fertilizer application. Being a leguminous crop, this crop requires only just a few starter dose of nitrogen because most of its requirement can be met from nitrogen fixation. Farmyard manure, that is FYM or compost, at the rate of 10 to 12 tons per hectare, 25 to 30 days before sowing, provides better yield. In general, groundnut requires about 20 kg nitrogen per hectare, 50 to 80 kg P2O5 and 30 to 40 kg K2O per hectare of land. Calcium has pronounced effect on proper development of pod and kernels. Calcium deficiency leads to formation of empty pods, that is pops. Application of gypsum at the rate of 125 kg per hectare is necessary. In areas where there is shortage of calcium in the soil, doses of gypsum may be as high as 400 kg per hectare. Next is about the cropping system which can be followed in groundnut. Groundnut is commonly grown in rotation with wheat, barley, chickpea, and lentil in northern India, while in south India it thrives on residual soil moisture after rice harvest. It is generally recommended that groundnut be rotated with well-fertilized cereal, whereby the cereal can take advantage of nitrogen fixation from groundnut. Next, we will see about intercropping. Groundnut can be grown intercrop with pigeon pea. They can also be grown intercrop with castor. Another one is groundnut with sunflower, groundnut with earth bean, groundnut with sesame. Coming up next is about the water management. Being a rainy season crop, groundnut requires no irrigation. But if there is prolonged dry spell, light but frequent irrigation during pegging and pod development stage is required. In areas where groundnut is grown in rabi season, 5 to 6 irrigation are necessary. And during summer, 10 to 12 irrigations may be needed depending on the soil moisture status. If only limited irrigation facilities are available, then priority should be given to irrigate at critical stages of development. The identified critical stages are flowering and pod development stages. IWY-CPE ratio for irrigation of groundnut is 0.6. Next, we will discuss about weed management. Groundnut is highly sensitive to weed during the first 25 to 45 days after planting. Therefore, it is essential to keep the field weed-free during this period. Application of pre-emergence herbicides such as pendimethalin at the rate of 1 to 1.5 kg active ingredient per hectare as spray, or flucloralin at the rate of 1 to 1.5 kg active ingredient per hectare as pre-plant soil incorporation, followed by 1 to 2 hand weeding as and when needed, effectively reduce weed competition. Once flowering and pegging begins, it is advisable to weed by hand pulling rather than by using a hoe, as this is less likely to disturb any developing pods. Next is about major insect pests of groundnut and its management. First one I would like to discuss is about white grub, and its management includes seed treatment with chlorpyrifos at the rate of 12.5 ml per kg of seed. This can also be managed by soil application of quinolfos or isophenfos at the rate of 1.5 kg active ingredient per hectare. Next is zecit, aphids, and thrips. Application of dimethoate 0.05% or monocrotophos 0.05% proved effective. Next is red hairy caterpillar. This can be managed by application of carbaryl or paration at the rate of 25 to 30 kg per hectare. Next is gram caterpillar. This can be managed by application of quinolfos 0.05% or carbaryl 0.2% or endosulfan 0.04%. Next is about the major diseases of groundnut and its management. The first one is early and late leaf spots. This can be managed by spray application of carvedazim, that is babestin 0.05% plus mancozeb 0.2% at 2 to 3 weeks intervals, 2 or 3 times starting from 4 to 5 weeks after planting. Next is rust. Spray application of tridemorph 0.7% at 14 to 21 days interval, 3 to 4 times after initiation of the infection, proved effective. Next is collar rot. This can be managed by seed treatment with ketan 80% wettable powder at the rate of 3 gram per kg of seed, or tiram 75% wettable powder at the rate of 3 to 5 gram per kg seed, or carvedazim 2 gram per kg of seed. The last one is bud necrosis. This bacteria can be controlled with methoate at the rate of 400 ml per hectare or methyl dimethone at the rate of 360 ml per hectare community basis. Now we will see about the harvesting practices. As flowering occurs for a long period and the pods are formed below the ground, it is difficult to determine maturity. In general, plants are considered mature when leaves become yellow and begins to fall, and inner side of the pod cells shows dark color with the seeds easily separated. In case of bunch type, mature groundnut are harvested by pulling out the plant with nuts attached. Harvesting of spreading type of groundnut is done by spade, local plow, or with the help of blade harrow or groundnut digger. Providing sprinkler irrigation for an hour or a light surface irrigation 2 to 3 days before harvest may help in case of hard soil surface. Harvested plant should be stacked in the field for a few days for air and sun drying on bright sunny days before stripping the pots. Now let's see about the dressing. Uprooted plants are generally stacked and dried in the field or on level platform for 2 to 3 days. Roots are usually placed upward so that pots are dried faster and uniformly. After drying, pots can be removed mechanically, picked by hand, and by rubbing the plants with the pots against the maize. Next is about the storage. After dressing, the maize, discolored, immature, as well as infected seeds are separated and stored in a clean, dry, and aerated place. Proper handling while harvesting or storage leads to infection with aspergillus and aflatoxin contamination. For proper and safe storage, the seeds in well-dried pots should have moisture less than 6 to 8%. Next is about the yield potential. By adopting the above mentioned practices, it is possible to obtain about 15 to 20 quintal of pods per hectare from bunch type varieties and 20 to 30 quintal per hectare from spreading type varieties. Now coming to the conclusion. Groundnut is one of the most important crops which are produced both as subsistence and commercial. It is used as a source of human food in different forms. Its husks are also used as fodder for cattle, and groundnut cake is also mixed in animal feeds or organic fertilizers. Proper understanding of various limiting factors of groundnut, including aflatoxin management, which is one of the major losses of groundnut, is very important. Introduction of new and improved practices for efficient use of resource is essential for increasing profitability and sustainability of groundnut production.